Now, let us do the laboratory method to find the surface tension of a liquid, for example, water. Now, let us discuss the Jaggert's method to determine the surface tension of water. Now, what is the basic principle of this method? You know, this excess of pressure inside a bubble is equal to, it is 4T by R. Excess of pressure of a soap bubble is 40 by R, but excess of pressure in a bubble inside water, it is P equal to 2 T by R. Now, applying this formula in this method, we can find the surface tension of water. This is the experimental arrangement of Jaggert's method. It consists of a Wolf's bottle. This is Wolf's bottle containing two mugs. You insert a thistle funnel in one mouth, then a tube BC is connected in the other opening, and in the BC tube a manometer M is connected. At the end of the tube B, a capillary tube is attached, and this capillary tube is placed or it is kept inside a liquid. If you add water in the thistle funnel and slowly you adjust the stopcock in this thistle funnel, so water is flowing through this tube, and what will happen to the air inside the bottle? The pressure inside the Wolf's bottle increases, pressure of air increases due to the flow of water into this bottle. So, in turn it will increase the pressure in the manometer. So, the levels of manometer will be changed, and what will happen at the free end of the capillary tube? It is immersed in a liquid, the experimental liquid. So, this air due to this pressure forces the liquid, forces down, and an air bubble is formed at this end. So, it has only one surface. An air bubble is formed at the free end of the capillary tube. When the bubble is detached at the free end, the manometer levels will be changed. At the time of detachment, you note the readings in the limbs of manometer, and the difference is H. And also you find the difference in or a depth of immersion of the capillary tube, that is H. So, these are the symbols used in this method. Surface tension of liquid is T, radius of the bubble is R, therefore, excess of pressure inside the bubble, it has 2 T by R. Since it has only one free surface, it is 2 T by R. Now, pressure of the liquid column, that is H rho 1 G. Now, you equate two pressures, pressure of the bubble and the pressure in the manometer. And if you equate these two parameters, you will get the result. Pressure of the liquid column H rho 1 G. H, depth of air bubble in water, rho 1 is the density of water. Let P be the atmospheric pressure. Therefore, the total pressure inside the bubble is given by atmospheric pressure, pressure due to the liquid column, and excess of pressure. So, P plus H rho 1 G plus 2 T by R, let it be the equation number 1. Now, what is the pressure in the manometer? Difference in levels in the two limbs of manometer, that is equal to H. You measure this difference in levels, let it be H. And density of liquid in the manometer, that is rho 2. Therefore, the pressure of air in the manometer is equal to P plus capital H rho 2 G. Let it be equation 2. Since the two pressures are equal, if you equate these two, you will get the surface tension. Equating 1 and 2, P plus H rho 1 G plus 2 T by R equal to P plus H rho 2 G. You cancel the atmospheric pressures. Therefore, if you simplify this equation, 2 T by R equal to H rho 2 minus H rho 1 g. Therefore, the surface tension T is given by g r by 2 h rho 2 minus h rho 1. Now, we have measured the h and small h, the depth of immersion in water and the manometric height, and you know the values of rho 2 and rho 1. This is density of experimental liquid, this is density of the manometric liquid. Now, what about r? For finding the radius of the orifice of the capillary tube, you can use mercury pellet method or travelling microscope. We have already discussed in viscosity how to find the radius using mercury pellet, and these are the experimental data. The radius of the tube that is equal to 0.75 into 10 power minus 3 meter. This is the radius of the inner bore. H, the difference in manometric height, that is 11 into 10 power minus 2 meter. The depth of immersion, that is 9.1 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Here rho 1 and rho 2 are equal, both the liquids are water, therefore the density is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Now, what is surface tension? If you substitute these values in the final formula of Jaggert's method, you can easily calculate the surface tension. Here rho 1 and rho 2 are equal, therefore you can take outside the bracket T equal to g r rho by 2 h minus h. Now, substitute the values 0.75 into 10 power minus 3 into 9.8 is g, into 10 cube is density of water, 11 it is the value of h, 9.1 it is the value of small h. And if you do the calculations, you will get T equal to 70 into 10 power minus 3 Newton per meter. So, this is the final result of Jaggert's method. Surface tension of water, that is 70 into 10 power minus 3 Newton per meter. Now, how will you repeat the experiment? You can repeat the experiment by changing the depth of immersion, that is h, and you find the average value, it will give the accurate value of surface tension of water. Now, what are the uses of Jaggert's method, or what are the advantages of Jaggert's method? Surface tension of a liquid at various temperatures, that means this method can be used to find the surface tension of liquid at various temperatures, and it is used to measure the surface tension of molten metal, and also it is used to compare the surface tension of two liquids at the same temperature. So, this method is very much useful to find the surface tension at different temperatures, and Jaggert found that the surface tension of all the liquids decreases as temperature increases. So, that is the conclusion from this Jaggert's method.